If you're doing affiliate marketing on your blog, or if you have banner ads on your sidebar, you probably know that your links should be NoFollow. But what exactly is that? And how do you make them NoFollow? All that and more is coming right up. Hey guys, it's Ileane from Basic Blog Tips. And before we get started, I want to give a random shout out to my girl, Anna Hoffman, over at Traffic Generation Cafe. Head over there every week. Anna does the weekly marketing skinny, and she will keep you up to date. You don't have to worry about missing anything that's going on in the world of business, Google, social media, or anything like that, because Anna does it every weekend. So check out Traffic Generation Cafe. Now, let's move on to how to make your links NoFollow. Now, when you have a blog or a website, Google and the other search engines will assign your site some level of authority. And when you link to another site, that means that you're passing some of your authority on to that site. So many years ago, Google decided that what they would do is, in case a link was paid, or in case the site owner decided that I want to link out to this piece of content, but I don't want to pass any of my authority to that link. That's how they developed this rel equals NoFollow, meaning the link is there, but I'm not passing my authority, or also known as link juice. That makes me thirsty when I start talking about link juice, so I'm going to take a sip. That was just vitamin water, you guys. So anyway, now we're back over on my blog, and when you're looking at anyone's blog, you can use a few extensions. Of course, I'm using Google Chrome. So one of the extensions that I like to use is called SEO Site Tools. Now, when I click on the SEO Site Tools extension, it's going to tell you a lot of things about your blog. But the piece that I want to talk about right now is where it will highlight NoFollow links. Now, there's a whole lot of extensions you can use. For Chrome, and I'm sure they have them for Firefox as well, or whatever browser you're using. So just look for an extension that shows NoFollow. So what will happen is all of the links that are NoFollow on this page will be highlighted in red. So as you scroll down, you see there's a few links here. This is an article that I wrote about Pinterest, where I was on the Manly Pinterest Tip Show with Jeff C. And here I've added a link here to a book that's on Amazon, and I made this NoFollow. Scroll down, you'll see also in my bio. Now that's a setting that I have in the plugin that I use for author bios. That means that any of the links in anyone's bio, not just mine, are all NoFollow. You'll see also in the commenting section where there's links, those links are NoFollow. And now down at the bottom, I do have an affiliate link for the theme that I'm using. Oops, I just realized this link is not NoFollow. So let's go over, and now I'm going to show you how to make a link NoFollow. Okay, now we're over in the back end of my WordPress dashboard, and I'm using the Genesis theme, and I'm also using a plugin called Simple Edits, and that allows me to edit things like the footer. So here is my affiliate link that I have already set up for the Appendipity themes. The Appendipity themes is like a framework that you're going to use on top of Genesis, just to describe that for you. So here's the link. It starts off with a little caret. Now, don't be intimidated by the code here. I'm not going to get deep into it, guys. I just want to show you this part. It starts off with the caret, and it ends with the ending caret, okay? And right here is where the words appear, which is Appendipity themes. So now this is what it links to. See where it starts with HTTP and goes all the way to here, where the end quotation marks. This is where we're going to insert rel equals nofollow. And this is the format. Okay? I'm going to type it in. This is real important, so this is why I'm going slow here. Rel equals quotation marks nofollow end quotation marks. All right, so this is how simple it is, guys. You have to enter rel equal quotation nofollow end quotation. That's it. That little piece right there. Okay? That's how simple it is. Now let's save settings. Now we're going to go back to the front end of the blog. I'm going to refresh the page. Boop! And there it is. It's highlighted as a nofollow link. Now, if you have a lot of content on your blog, it may seem like a daunting task to go back and make all those links nofollow that are leading to your affiliate products. You make sure you want to have a good mix of follow and nofollow links on your blog. I'm not saying to make them all nofollow, but I would start off with the ones that are on your sidebar because they appear on every page on your blog. Start off with that, and then moving forward, just remember, rel equals nofollow. And as long as you do that, you'll be all right. Now, I have more useful tips like that coming your way, so make sure you subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video. It's Ileane from Basic Blog Tips, signing off, saying peace.